Okay.
What is that?
Try full screening it again. Try doing it again.
No, I don't want to touch anything right now. God, fuck it. I'm leaving this in. Fuck this game.
This game has bugs. Okay, go show the controller bug. Just do it.
Fucking .mu. Like, hold on.
.mu. I know you guys probably really like SNK games, but, okay. Like, get your shit together. Just, all of these games are busted.
Like, I was just setting my buttons, and, like the fact that you change... Well, it's not... I don't think it's gonna work now since I've already saved them.
Yeah, that's true.
But, like, it gives you a prompt, or it asks you, do you want to say yes or no? And you go to no, and then it leaves you on that screen with your changes anyway. And then you go back again, and then it go back in, and your buttons are still...
So even if you say no...
It still has them changed.
It fucks up what it says in the menu.
It says they're changed, but then you go to play the game, and they're not changed.
That's stupid.
So it's just a stupid basic menu bug.
That's bad.
That's QA shit.
You see the bit where they got this beautiful Metal Slug X logo, and they got all the pixel art nice and preserved in the background, and they just took this Shinkiro art and just fucking Photoshop, Control F, squish, expand, until you get this, like, jank
Shinkiro
mess.
Shinkiro slaved hours
it's
to
beautiful.
Get these Mel Gibson faces rendered.
His art is
to a high
beautiful.
Quality, and you've just fucking, what have you done with it?
They've squashed and stretched it to death.
They converted it to GIF, then back to JPEG.
Yeah, exactly.
Then down to BMP, up to GIF. Fuck. Okay.
I'm sure the game's fine.
I'm sure it is, but we're already missing the arcade intro that we would be getting.
Oh yeah, we don't get to see the intro.
Because
oh.
.mu. Thanks.
Oh well.
Let's just fucking go, I guess.
Let's do it. Okay. This'll be good.
Alright.
What is very hard? What is very hard in this context?
More life.
Let's not touch it.
Probably
but...
more damage on the enemies. More life.
No. Let's not touch it.
No. Nope.
But I'm curious, because I've never bothered to pick anything above hard.
Yo!
I get to say airy.
Okay.
The girls in this series
so
are
So right off
than
the
guys.
Bat, did you see that in the background?
Yes, I did see that in the background.
So the reasons why we wanted to go through Metal Slug 2 first, and not straight to X... As you saw there, they fucking show you the,
aliens.
The aliens.
The Mars people.
Right away, you get a glimpse of that.
Whoops. Well, we're really good at Metal Slug.
Totally amazing, you guys.
Hey, we don't get paid to play Metal Slug.
No, they right away give that away. Like I didn't even realize how soon. But when you said it was, they gave it away too early. Like second one.
We'll start encountering them, too, in a little while. To be honest, I don't remember if that UFO was there in the original release or not, like in Metal Slug 2, but I know you encounter them, like, way earlier, as opposed to in Metal Slug 2, where you encounter them pretty much just at the finale.
Yeah.
And then you team up with your, like, Super Canada Man.
At least, it was at least a halfway point.
Very near the end, anyway, yeah.
Now...
So one of the main fixes that I think is like noticeable right off the bat is the frame rate.
The frame rate is not eating shit.
Yeah, because even in the original arcade release, the frame rate was very poor in Metal Slug 2.
And it was
that's just known.
And Metal Slug 2, we still enjoyed that game.
Oh, it's good. Yeah.
But we totally saw the horseshit frame rate that it became slowly.
Immediately.
Also, there was the fact that. There's like balancing issues that
Look at those Mars people right there.
Right there, right?
It's right out of the gates. Sorry, you're saying balancing issues?
That SNK just wasn't happy with.
Get the baby.
And
look at the baby. Look at him.
Did you see it?
They animated him flipping over? Beautiful.
Out of control. These
it's
guys.
Like poetry.
No one asked them to put this much frame work into the game.
Stop putting frames in. You're running us broke.
It's the opposite of D3 Publisher.
Yeah. Well, D3 Publisher is like simple series. This is the overly complex series.
Too complex.
Too much art.
Yeah, so here we're seeing just a remix of Metal Slug 2, the game we just played.
Yeah, pretty much.
With a bit more going on. Ooh, no.
But it's been a few weeks. Everyone forgets what that game looks like now, so.
Yeah. It might as well be a fucking new game entirely.
I mean, fuck, I only remember like the first and last levels really well. Oh shit.
Could we back up to avoid this thing from firing?
I think it'll still fire, but... Oh, it only fires that far? Oh, okay.
Okay, then you're fine.
Well, never mind. It's not... Oh, yeah, grenades. There we go.
We can switch sides here.
There's a heavy machine gun there. Oh, well, we're good. Yeah, we fucking did it. Did you notice we're getting better at these games?
We're great.
We're great, man.
I guess so.
I've never seen that before.
Yeah. Oh, we got a little achievement in the
We got
corner.
A fucking Steam achievement. Dot M, you did the Steam achievements. That's, I guess, it's something. Get your laser.
Laser.
Yeah, so we're going down. I'm pretty sure you can go up there, and I'm pretty sure we went down last time as well.
Oh shit! Okay, let's try to branch next time.
I don't remember where the other branches are.
Neither do I, unfortunately.
Because 3 branches all the goddamn time. Like,
yeah,
3 has like I think 50 something unique routes. It's kind of ridiculous, actually. Oh, we gotta kill him. Yeah.
Don't get zombified.
Yeah, if you crouch, you can avoid their thing entirely.
Up. Up.
Yeah, let's go up.
Or did we go up last time?
I don't know.
Shit.
We probably went up. We went up last time.
We went up last time.
Remember, if you crouch, you can avoid their shit, yeah, so.
But now they're on an angle, though.
Yeah, the ones below you, you'll get fucked by. Or breathed on, or whatever. Oh, that's beautiful. When these guys flip out, look at that animation. Looks like they're 3D. Look at that.
Yeah, little zombie dudes.
Amazing.
Little zombie pooch.
The way they belong.
Oh. Oh no, they got me.
Okay, so the zombie pups do turn you into that too.
Yeah. Their zombie barf totally gets you.
Yeah, you can get him.
It's hard when he's below me though.
Yeah. Well, now and you're super stiff now too with those controls. Oh my god, those fire animations are stupid.
We didn't fight. Now the dogs were not all.
I don't recall. No, here, you can go grab that. Oh, it vanished.
Shit, I was too slow. Hey, we healed him.
I love how the prisoners stick their hands out and they like beckon for you to come over. Like, no, you're tied up. You're tied up. Stop doing that.
Totally.
You're ruining the movie.
But you can't crouch the dogs, though.
No.
The dogs are the counter.
They are the counter to that strategy.
Yeah.
They're the paper to your scissors. I mean, that was paper to your rock.
That was some of the balancing that SNK wanted done.
I suppose so. So those guys, they only swing if you stop under them. Yeah, and then they drop it. Yeah. If you're still moving under them, they won't actually release.
So item lady, that we saw there. I was actually reading about how there's 2 of them.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and like they're sisters, and it actually changes
depending on the game.
Her hairstyle is very subtle difference between her and her sister.
I never would have known.
Yeah, no, it's nuts. I didn't fucking catch that either.
World building, people.
SNK establishing.
SNK establishing Metal Slug worlds
before anyone else was willing to.
Well, who else would?
Well, who else even makes like old school games like this that feel old school but play in an amazing
like at the time just Konami like and even
Treasure
then,
I guess
Treasure I guess but now they're onto Geist Crusher was really bad and fuck
like Gunstar Heroes was how long ago you know.
Gunstar Heroes was like an age. It was an absolute age. It was on the Genesis. I mean, you know.
Yeah.
You tell me.
And like,
I mean, they did do as much as it's got its faults. They did advance. What's it called? What was the GBA port?
Advanced Guardian Heroes.
Not Guardian Heroes. Gunstar Heroes.
Super Gunstar Heroes.
It was Super Gunstar Heroes. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. They did Super Gunstar Heroes, which was again like not as good as the Genesis one, but I mean they did it. But at this point in time, I don't know, there were never all that many companies making these types of games, let alone at this type of fidelity.
No,
this type of fidelity is just, like, completely unheard of.
Everyone just gave up. Everyone just super gave up.
Well, they went where the money did.
Yeah!
SNK did, and SNK took a long time to go where the money is, which was pachinko.
But these were the vanity years, right?
Yeah, basically.
I mean, I imagine Metal Slug had to be, like, somewhat profitable for them to keep going at
it. Oh, I'm sure it did well, but,
And doing the one thing that I wanted with the franchise was getting my Ikari Warriors in there.
Yeah.
You know, that's another franchise they abandoned.
I think more or less, they just got to a point where it wasn't paying the bills. And, you know, we saw them releasing, stuff like Metal Slug 7 and XX and stuff. And those games were selling, dismal numbers. They were doing so bad. There was no arcade releases, of course. And,
Yeah.
I mean, as much as, you know, we don't really go by it. Oh, shit.
Ugh.
As much as we don't really go by it, graphics like these don't wow a lot of people. You know, they're not big 3D explosions in your face,
that
you know?
That fucking sucks, man.
It does suck, but it's...
Hey, wait!
It's not hard to see that, as a layman, you wouldn't...
All right, you can take it this time.
You wouldn't necessarily, appreciate... the artistry. Not to say we're amazing artists or anything, or connoisseurs, but, you know.
Yeah.
Your mom wouldn't necessarily get why this game's beautiful. And I mean, your mom wasn't in the arcades anyway, but at a certain point, I mean, you know as well as I do, everything had to go 3D and just shut down every other game.
What is this old cartoony shit?
Yeah.
It doesn't look serious enough.
Shit, I accidentally jumped out of the Metal Slug.
Oh no. Metal Slug would never be on the top 10 most serious games.
No. That's reserved for Fighting Lair.
Oh god.
Fighting Lair's real.
It's so real. Use your grenades too.
Oh yeah. Oh shit.
Yeah. That happened both. That's gonna take a while to get used to reading that.
Yeah,
man.
For sure. Oh. Oh, whoops.
Oh, no. This boss is... Yeah. The slug really helps.
Yeah, perfect. I jumped all the way in, and I'm still invincible, so I'm fine. Well, the slug just gets so much raw damage in there so quickly.
And it lets you constantly aim down and not have to jump anymore.
Yeah, pretty much. The reason I accidentally jumped out of it was because holding down and pressing jump is to jump out.
Right.
And so when I was aiming down.
How trivialized would this game be if there was twin stick controls?
It'd be a joke, dude.
It'd be a complete joke.
It would be a complete farce if you could move and shoot completely independently.
In all directions,
It would be a joke. It would be an utter joke. There's no two ways around that.
Firebomb. Yeah.
I wouldn't want to play that. Well, I remember even just, when we were going into... I don't remember if it was I think it was the second one, where we debated using, Actually, we didn't debate using it. We turned it on, the auto-fire,
and then instantly
turned it off because it's basically cheating.
Too busted.
Yeah.
Way too busted.
So, the notion of having twin stick, because by the nature of twin stick, you just hold in the direction and shoot.
And damage will occur.
Yeah, so the best way to fix that would be to make them have to, mash in a direction. But then that wouldn't be fun either, so... You know, no matter which way you do it, you end up either OP or just making something not fun at all. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck.
But nowadays, twin stick is the only form that would continue to come out of this type of genre.
Of, run-and-gun shmups? Yeah, or shmups. Yeah. Run-and-gun, shooters? Probably. Pretty much.
I can't take the low road? No, okay.
But we don't even get all that many, 2D shooters anyway nowadays. There was,
The digital, Devolver has a bunch.
Devolver, that are shooters? That aren't, other, odd subgenre breakdowns?
What am I thinking of? There's a Devolver game I saw a trailer for that just looked like a crazy shooter.
It's well possible, Ronin or something.
I don't remember what.
Not a Hero?
Not a Hero. That's
not a Hero. Yeah, Not a Hero is really cool. Cause I was gonna say there was the one by Tribute Games as well, Mercenary Kings.
Yes.
That game wasn't so good, but.
I guess Broforce to some degree, right? You gotta.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. Meme Force.
it was fun.
It was fun, but I found the joke, it was free on PS Plus, so I've played it, a bunch now, and I found the joke kinda runs its course. Yeah, a little bit.
We were talking about on just my last podcast about
how
amazed we were that, it's still going.
Yeah, we've been hearing about this game being out and playing it for like over like a year and a half now or some shit.
Yeah.
And there was the what's that movie called again?
The tie-in with the Expendables?
Expendables, thank you. There was an Expendables tie-in. Was that for Expendables 2 or 3?
Yeah, it was 2.
Because, fuck, we've had a third movie now.
Yeah.
So...
So...
Yeah, it broke my heart that game won the poll on PSN for, like, what game's free this month. I was really hoping Assault Android Cactus would take it, because that game's sick.
I don't even... What?
It is a sick top-down twin-stick shooter.
Okay.
Topical, since that's all that gets made, according to us.
Oh, God, just dropping tanks. The idea of a Harrier attacking you deliberately with its hover jets is pretty sick, though.
Yeah, for sure. But the notion that it's carrying tanks with the express purpose of jettisoning them...
Yeah, totally.
Like, is that really the best weapon you've got?
That's what the fucking Canadian Nova Scotia Army is all about.
Why not just skip a step and crash the plane into the train? Why not just end it there?
Kamikaze.
Yeah, no, exactly. Why not put... Oh, we got drop shot. Oh, I died with drop shot. Why not just put one of those tanks you're going to kamikaze in the way of the train? Why not just... You know...
Don't
you know
the Canadian tactics.
General Morton kind of knows what's up.
I think we said Nova Scotia. I think it might have been New Brunswick.
I think it was New Brunswick or Nova Scotia. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Definitely one of those two places, though.
As if a distinction.
Yeah, let me get in that plane.
Yeah.
Were you saying as if the distinction matters?
Between the two.
Oh, harsh words. Tell that to Nova Scotia.
Like, Nova Scotia's a little bit more French because they have Acadians. That's it.
That's just a rumor.
Like, okay, you tell me about the difference between Wyoming culture and,
Wyoming, does it even have a culture? Like
yeah, like, that's what, you know? I can't even think of another.
There we go. Go ahead. You're piloting
defeat
this ship.
Defeat us now! What is your plan?
This reminds me of, you remember the PS3 game Warhawk?
Yeah.
So in Warhawk, you could drive tanks or jeeps on top of planes, and if you played extremely carefully, you could have a tank on top of a plane, and you could do this.
That's awesome.
That game was amazing. Super, super underrated.
Well, it was the main thing was the controller moving, right? The
tilt thing?
Yeah.
That was a feature for sure. The main thing was like just the like insanely gigantic battles.
It was a six-axis game.
Yeah, I mean, there was that. But the gigantic battles was definitely the thing. I think it was 32 players, which at the time was crazy.
Okay, we are in the optimal form for this fucking boss.
Oh, shit.
We were.
I hope that doesn't blow up the plane.
No, I hope it doesn't seem like it. But these giant fucking cannonballs, probably.
Don't forget to use your...
Yeah, my payload.
I don't remember if this thing tries to squish you. Oh, here it comes. You got 4 more missiles. Yeah, okay.
I'm using them.
Good.
Shit.
A hold down and jump. Yeah, there you go. Okay, so there's the blonde girl. What was the color of the hair of the last
one? They're both blonde, but it's just a different hairstyle.
Okay. Yeah, I took your heavy machine gun. My bad. My B.
What's happening right now? Okay.
Oh,
you're Fio. Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
I was like, what?
Everyone wants to be Fio.
Everyone needs to be Fio. Fio wants to be Fio.
Yeah, we did it. I actually feel like we're improving at these games. I don't know if I'm just saying that. Like,
I think you're just saying it, maybe.
I need to see the quarter count. I need to see the quarter count. We're getting better at the bosses, though, that's for sure.
Yeah, although I've been having a rough run. Like, I had a bunch of stupid deaths early on in this.
Yeah, but we've been decreed great twice. That's a plus.
Fair enough. Well, you were, player two.
Mission. Oh, I thought it was you the first time.
Shoot up Chinatown.
What a good song. And even then, it's really just that bit that I like.
Just the beginning.
But I like that bit so much. Great.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, we're totally better at this.
You can see it. Oh, big.
That reminds me of fucking Wii Fit, where you stand on the board and it goes, oh. And you're like, what do you mean, oh? What do you fucking mean, oh? Give it to me straight, Wii Fit board. Am I a fat fuck?
Oh, no.
Oh. I love those, like, jelly, like, things that they shoot that go woo woo woo, and they make the warbling sound as they go along.
Yeah, yeah. So the bus doesn't take damage until it decides. Great. You know, I never thought about it, but you know those...
Yeah, like, drop shot.
You know those Contra wall bosses?
Yeah?
Like, just the wall of fucking destruction?
Yes, absolutely. Like at the end of the first level?
The side of a double-decker bus can really just be one of those if you want it to be.
Totally, totally.
If you try hard enough.
They could be repurposed. There's gonna be something really cool that we missed along the top path.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, shit, like a tank.
Fuck! Okay, there we go. Laser! Oh, your shield! Fuck your shield!
What are those guys?
They're scuba units.
Like scuba mans?
Yeah.
The one thing I never liked about the laser was that, unlike the machine gun, it doesn't fire shot. Oh, he did the Hadouken. Did you see that?
Is he doing it? Yeah!
Yeah, look at it. Or what's the SNK one called?
Hao Shokoken.
Yeah, he's doing it. And he's going to follow us around, and he's going to keep doing it on enemies as much as he can.
Keep him alive.
This guy, by the way, has a name.
Yeah, he does.
I don't remember his name.
But he does have
a name. See, here's the Mars people right off the bat.
With no explanation.
Yeah. So, yeah, like I was saying, when you fire the laser and you move it from direction to up or to down, it doesn't get any in-between shots in the middle. Like, it only fires in the four cardinal directions.
Yeah, and the machine gun does better.
Pretty much every other rapid-fire weapon, and I think even the handgun can be fired in eight directions.
You got a fat laser.
If you do it right. Yeah, the fat laser's really cool. Still doesn't shoot in, like, eight directions, but whatever. Oh.
Big. just gotta use that every time.
You boot their sports games and it says SNK big.
Big. No, just like you're feeling a little fat after a meal.
Oh. Oh.
Big. That's great.
Oh, shit.
All right, Eri.
You know what we have to do? This is a lesson I know we've learned before in the past, but we've lost it between Metal Slug games. We have to use our grenades more during regular gameplay.
Yes. Absolutely, because we're dying without using them, because we're thinking too special of them.
Yeah.
And then it all goes for naught. Like, every couple seconds, just toss one. Just, there you go.
Just for good measure.
Just to get the use in.
You never know. Oh, yeah, this boss. This boss is sick. Grenades.
Yeah, I can't turn around, though.
Oh, yeah, that is kind of restrictive, isn't it? Fortunately, I have a shock. Oh.
There's the hitbox.
Where's hitbox?
Wait for it. There we go.
There's the cool thing. Oh, yeah, and it's got the giant shells that fall out after. You remember that?
Yeah, and it tracks. Oh. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Yeah, all right. Oh. That's the right angle. Hadouken Man? No,
he's gone. That's it. I remember these bosses taking a lot longer last time we played. Maybe it was just me.
Yeah, well, the slug makes a difference. The slug.
That's true. You had a slug,
difference.
Yeah.
Draw.
I don't even know, man. Mission
complete. Feels all sneezing.
Is that what she does?
Yeah, she sneezes and Ares happy.
I thought she was just doing the Japanese rub your nose.
Like, the fact that they're dropping in their soldiers on, plank wood.
On planks of wood? Yeah, exactly.
It's just like, we don't have enough to, like...
Find Canadian lumber.
We don't have enough parachutes to support everybody. Drop in two or three at a time.
You get the plank, and the next guy gets the clip.
Great. and just Dumbo drop these fucking Dumbo drop these tanks.
Metal Slug Operation Dumbo Drop.
Totally fine.
Dumbo's getting dropped in and you have to kill him.
In midair. Okay.
Oh, big.
yeah, okay. Oh, shit.
Yeah, good dodge. Good dodge.
Move forward and...
You know what? You know what would be sick? If Metal Slug had a parry button.
Oh, dude.
And you could just parry bullets by hitting the button right before it happens, you know?
Well...
Or, like, the knife,
well,
you know?
Here's
like,
the thing. The closest we're gonna get to that will be,
Ralph and Clark's stuff.
Yes.
Yeah, their inputs and their commands.
Save that shit. Save it.
I don't remember their commands, so that's gonna be
it's
a fun experience.
It's just a straight-up melee button.
Oh, that's it? Okay. I thought, for some reason, I thought there was quarter circles involved.
There are, no, you can do moves.
Okay, yeah, I thought so, yeah.
But you do moves with the end, with the...
Because that's what's so exciting about it. Did you ever play Castlevania Portrait of Ruin?
That was the third?
The second DS one.
Second DS,
with,
no.
Charlotte and Jonathan.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah.
Yeah, you did? Okay.
Didn't beat it or anything. But.
Okay. If you get deep enough into that game, at some point you start getting action commands for the characters involving half circles and stuff like that.
Like Alucard.
Yeah, kind of like Alucard had. Exactly.
Like dark metamorphosis.
Yeah, but it's all like physical stuff as opposed to spells.
Okay.
Like getting dodge rolls and stuff like that. Which is really cool because no other character really has dodge rolls. Oh, I got the big laser.
Nice.
Why is it so big this time?
I don't know. It's like a...
I actually have no idea why that is.
Was it just an L?
It seemed to be just an L.
You've leveled up your laser, I guess.
Oh. Oh, big.
Sure.
Okay, this is the train place where we have to fight the train off good and
yes.
not get squished like a chump.
No, don't.
Because we did that. Get the big laser.
Oh, God.
Oh, it's a bulb. Look at it. It's pulsing.
It's pulsing, yeah.
Laser gun.
Oh, this is a fucking tricky room.
Yeah, the bullet, the pattern's narrow.
Yeah. There we go. Okay, we're ready this time. Right?
I think. Yeah, here we go. Perfect.
I chickened out. Don't forget. In case grenades.
Oh, the grenades, yeah, of course.
In case grenades.
I was abusing the laser for a while, so I felt it suitable to not use them. Great.
Alright, I'm out of grenades. Good.
Good. Good job, Wooly. Smoke if you got them.
Exactly. Damn, wasted the enemy chaser. Like.
Hey, I got a medal.
Oh shit, again.
Oh fuck.
Okay, back up for this one.
Dodge, duck. Great, great, perfect.
Oh god.
Yeah, we're totally better. We're totally not dying every other second just like last time.
No second train? Okay.
There is a second train, so it's probably gonna come in here.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, back all the way up as much as possible.
Yeah, we got it. He's
free. This train is free.
Till another one comes from behind. Oh my god, die.
Dude!
Ah, there we go.
Yeah, okay. Hey.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. We're too close.
It's fine.
It's not gonna work.
Oh. Yeah! Super grenade.
Use those.
Fuck.
No.
I'm coming.
No. Ah. Fuck that.
Oh, fuck that knife guy for ruining us.
It's so hard to turn around when you're alone.
Is it in single player? Is it balanced differently?
It must be. It must be.
Or else it just kills you free.
There's no way.
Like, they would have to give you a weapon or something, but even then, that doesn't make sense.
Okay.
count. We want that big laser, so you never really get a what?
An explanation for what these critters are.
No, not really. Wait.
I assume they're Mars people experimentation.
I was gonna say, I vaguely remember, like, in the last level, like, Morden was doing some shit with the alien tech, but maybe I'm misremembering.
I'm assuming. Good laser.
Let's keep moving forward, though, because they'll spawn infinitely.
Yeah.
So we need to...
Oh, God, there's one hot on my ass. There we go.
Walk.
Doing good.
Let's get that slug. Protect me real quick.
Good.
There we go.
Keep moving.
It's going good, actually, so far.
Absolutely. Just don't look back. Grenade the shit out of this thing. Keep moving. Sick. Oh, no! Thank you. Okay. Rocket
launcher.
Ouch. Lounge chair. Yep. Motherfucker. Just like 18 grenades.
Totally not wasteful. What are you talking about?
I didn't crouch that. Alright, we have his number. We got the weapons ready to go.
Oh yeah, it was this thing. The sphere. Oh yeah, these things, you remember?
Yes, I do.
And they start going towards you.
Damn. Fuck!
Shit! I forgot about that.
Heavy machine gun.
Oh, I had grenades. You got one more.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Ooh.
Fuck this tunnel vision.
Got it. Nope, don't got it. Far from got it. Never had it.
Like, we are jinxing ourselves harder than any other time in any other series.
This confidence.
You got 10
bad.
Grenades, by the way.
Yes, I do. This confidence is super bad. There we go.
There we go.
Abandoned ship.
Jump into the sludge.
God, it's not even sewer. It's just.
It's
like,
green.
It's green.
Mission complete.
Super warrior achievement. Final mission. Alright.
Okay, we do
this
it.
Song.
This song's super good too.
Oh, can't touch
the
water.
Oh, I like that. The freezing thing.
Can't touch the water.
I always hated those rockets.
Because they don't actually blow up.
Yeah, they don't blow up.
It's really annoying.
You're just fighting against them.
It's their pace.
Yeah. Nice, good jump. You can do it. There we go.
Got it.
Now we got the Iron Chaser, we can't be beat.
Perfect.
Except for my aerial foes who I literally can't shoot.
Because the Chaser refused.
It just goes down. The Chaser refused to change.
It looks at you like, sorry, man. I was built for one purpose.
Oh, shit.
To chase.
Oh, you can duck under that. Cool.
Don't ask me to do things that don't involve chasing.
Oh, I think we talked about this last time, but this bridge is so sick.
It's really good. It's really annoying at the same time, though.
Yes.
You gotta keep moving. Like, who is causing it to do that?
It's like that bridge in San Francisco or whatever.
Where the wind just keeps going.
Where the wind just made it fucking buckle left and right one time. And by one time, I mean all the time.
Yeah. Oh, this is where he is.
Oh, yeah, this guy. I wonder if you can crouch under his bullets. You can.
Did that straight up work? Really?
Yep. But the diagonal bullets are dangerous.
Oh, God, I forget his name, but he fucking... He's the most resilient soldier.
I looked him up. He dies a bunch of times in various Metal Slug games and just comes back.
Yeah, he just says nah.
Grenades, grenades, grenades. There we go. But he will come back. He is literally not dead.
No matter what his bones tell you.
Yeah, yeah. That's true.
Keep forgetting his fucking name. God. Well, final mission, so no time to check.
No time to remember. No help from friend.
Press on. Murder.
What the fuck was that from anyway? No help from friend.
No help from friend was, what's that fucking fighter?
Oh, it was an assist thing.
It was Examu.
Oh,
Vanguard Princess.
Vanguard Prince. No, not Examu, but Vanguard Princess is very Examu looking. Examu didn't make it.
Oh, okay.
They did Arcana Heart and Nitro Plus Blasters and
yes,
stuff.
Yes, okay,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah. No, it was.
They're the anime guys. Vanguard Princess aren't the anime guys.
all right. I guess you're right. No, you're right. You're actually right. Yeah.
Yeah, I ran into something. I didn't even see it. So, we haven't even gotten back to fighting Mars people. We fought them right at the beginning. Here we go. We finally get back to them.
Yeah.
This is where they would normally be introduced. I think they're introduced in a slightly more subtle way in 2, if I remember correctly, where you see one running off screen or something. Am I remembering that right?
Yeah, you see a thing and you go, what was that?
Yeah. And we made it super dramatic.
And here it's just like, no, you already know.
You already know what's up. You saw them in the first level.
Drop shot.
Fuck, I can't hit anything.
Right, and then we were saying that these are the lower class Mars peoples.
Yeah, exactly.
Got it. There you go. Could you imagine this game with friendly fire on?
No. Dude, I would not want to play that game. That sounds like not fun.
That's not even remotely fun.
Like fucking horrible. I'm sure they considered it.
Like type B.
Yeah. Oh my god. Dude, the amount of like care and planning you'd have to put into your play as a cooperative group would far surpass any enjoyment.
No fun from friends.
Great.
I wish we got Hadoukens more often.
I think he only appears like once in each game following this one. Okay. I don't think he appears before this game, actually. But I think he only appears once in the game. I might be wrong, but pretty sure. I'm probably wrong. Some Hispanic fan will tell us otherwise. They know.
They know so well.
And for those who don't know, Mexico
is
SNK land.
Loves SNK.
Yeah.
For very good reason. 25 cent games. Cheaper than anything else in the machine.
Or whatever peso conversion, right?
Yeah. Because, you know, Capcom going for that 50 cents. Sometimes
it's too much. It's too much.
Sometimes a dollar.
And you can't even blame them. Like, as much as I don't really like KOF as much as Street Fighter, like, the quality's there, you know? So.
Yeah. No.
At the time, they were totally.
It's a cheaper solution, and the game is just as fun.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that was good. Like we're now getting into like Galaga patterns.
Yeah. No, I really like how the Mars people work.
And you can shoot their bullets.
I really hope that I'm sure they will. I don't think this has ever really left SNK, but I really hope that they continue existing in a world where they constantly cross over their stuff. You know, like Leona is a KOF character who is in KOF, but like, you know, she's kind of a Metal Slug character too, a little bit. So
at this point, yes. At this point, they fully belong. You know, and I mean,
like Fio, I want a Mars Fio, person as DLC for KOF.
Well, Fio being fightable, being playable in Maximum Impact 2. That was the comeuppance day.
Well, and the Mars person in
Neo Geo
Battle
Coliseum.
Yeah. That shit's awesome.
Like, I would like there to be a proper sequel to iCarry Warriors for real, someday.
God, yeah.
Just for fun, because that, I actually...
Just for fun.
Because funny enough, like, I'm a weirdo, but, like, I played that game before Contra.
Hmm, okay.
Because, like, that's what was in my
house.
That's just
what happened, yeah.
You know? So I have much more love.
Yeah, you did it.
Initially.
Yep.
No, we never really find out where the mutants come from.
No, I thought there was something, but I guess I'm crazy. The betrayal tone's not really so amazing the second time around.
Not necessarily. We also still don't know what their motives are.
No, but that will all be revealed in future Metal Slug games.
To conquer Nova Scotia.
Christ.
All right.
There are, like, scant areas more useless than Nova Scotia.
I mean, we let them into the Union, but, like, I don't know what Johnny McDonald was thinking.
We don't accept them.
Like, Newfoundland at least offers fish. Sure, they're not too smart, but sometimes I feel like eating fish.
Rocket launcher.
Grenades, when possible.
Yeah, let me get those out. You can jump on this roof, so
yeah.
that's the spot for grenades.
That's true.
But watch out for the Mars people's laser beams. Woo!
Good dodging. Until that happens.
Yeah. It's the ultimate game of Jinx. We can't say anything about our good performance, because we're going to die instantly if we do. Okay, on to phase two.
I'm right in the perfect spot for that. Oh no. Cause yeah, like they gave Morden the baby ship and he painted it with a stupid logo.
Here, enjoy this. It's true, he put his logo
he
on
put
it.
Put his stupid fucking logo and they're like, ah fuck this.
This stupid loser can keep the baby ship. Don't tell him guys.
Oh, God.
And then the theme comes on, and the soldiers come out. It's fucking beautiful.
Yeah. It's not... You know what? This is actually a lot closer to 2 than I remembered. I remembered this being way different.
Yeah, me too.
But
it was mostly subtle changes and, like, balanced stuff that, you know, we're gonna have a hard time perceiving.
Whatever. It's Metal Slug. Oops, we accidentally filmed another episode.
Oops, we put Metal Slug on camera.
More Metal Slug. Boo. Oh, no.
Oh, and there's a guy in a tank right there. That's great.
Oh, God, fuck these fucking... Okay, doing it.
My heavy machine gun.
Ooh. Oh, no. Wow. That was a good run for me. Yeah, and it's almost not even worth it to, like, attack the ships, the saucers.
I mean, like, maybe it is.
They take so long to
I don't know.
Though.
You don't know. We have to use our grenades on
them.
Oh,
I used the human shields as one of the soldiers.
Oh, you used one of the soldiers?
Yeah. Like, I crouched
that's
right behind
great.
Him, and he took the hit.
That's actually a great strategy. Maybe that's actually what they're for.
Stand on top of them, and they'll take the hit.
Let me just get under this metal slug. We got the Hadouken guy right there.
Doing it.
So never mind, I am totally crazy.
Everybody contributes.
I like how these UFOs just fly away once they've dealt with us.
Yeah.
Like, they don't even bother sticking around.
Because
they're like,
shit.
Yeah, we won already. But did
look at the background. They did win.
It's true, they did win.
When you can see nothing but death and fire on the horizon.
But did you win, though?
Yeah, forgot about Bill Paxton.
Man, you would never get such a blatant homage in a game nowadays. Like, for a movie of the era.
What was the gap in
time between Independence Day and Metal Slug 2?
Couldn't have been more than, like... Must have been like 4 years.
Yeah, exactly.
But like, what movie like meme has hit
the, has hit that
the mind the zeitgeist that hard?
You know, there's stuff, but I'd be pressed to name it right now. Dead.
Like, no matter
killed.
What. Yeah, no, there's nothing really, like, on that level, you know? Luke, I am your father, and so on. Like, as we go forward into time, an Independence Day reference is pretty obscure by comparison to the big ones over the years.
Yeah, for sure.
Nothing recently, I guess. Just because there's a lot.
So, okay, so there's our continue number, so that's under 40. We did a sub-40 run.
Yeah, that's true.
We should mark this video as a sub-40 continue run, because that's pretty good, I'm sure. I don't think many people have done that before.
So that was 37
credits.
37 credits?
Which is a bit under $10.
Okay.
That's I think that's $9.25.
Perfect.
That's not bad.
Less than $20. Good
we,
time.
We've had runs that were $20 ones,
yeah,
haven't we?
Yeah, no, yeah, absolutely.
So no, we have been doing a bit better at least. We still ate shit when it came to like the last boss. We're still really bad at that, but one day we'll get used to it.
I just want to take an extra moment to double fuck down on fucking Dot
Double
MU.
Fuck down.
Because these credits are not.
Is this how they were originally? Like,
I don't know, but I remember it being the tank screen. Maybe it changed for X. Maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I have no idea.
Either way, though,
this is probably the original.
Could be. But .mu, man, I don't know why they keep getting work. It feels like they were
hired. I think
hired.
They did them all at one time.
I think
you know
that's
what I mean?
The only
like,
explanation.
It was a package bundle, probably.
There's no reason why you'd go back to them, you know?
I mean,
after
they probably had
done.
The right price, too, you know?
Fucking free?
Yeah, exactly. Well, now Code Mystics is doing, like, amazing ports of their stuff. Right now it's just Metal Slug and, fuck me, what's the other one? No, it's just Metal Slug right now. And Last Blade 2's coming. And, like, based on how good Code Mystics' ports have been, I expect them to totally rectify these issues, but...
When I play...
Who even knows when they'll do another Metal Slug?
But when your job is to just make a menu and let the ROM run, and I find a bug in your fucking menu...
Yeah.
And you can't, and like, not to mention...
Also, when your job is just let the ROM run, like, grab, like, steal that emulator.
Right?
Yeah.
Oof, that guy got away.
Enemy's brain credits.
My computer's fan starts going crazy whenever I boot this up.
Yeah, which
is
weird, because it doesn't do that for shit like Street Fighter V.
Nothing else.
Like,
only these .mu games. And...
.mu games are like, yo, turn that fan up. What cooling gel?
It needs processing power to run a fucking Metal Slug game. Like, it's the stupidest shit. And every time the game boots up onto full screen initially, it changes your TV from game mode.
Oh yeah, you mentioned
back
that.
Into normal mode. Does a complete refresh on your screen and darkens everything on your settings. Like, what the fuck game does that? Nothing.
I don't know, man. I don't know. It's just a bummer.
I don't know if they're still in business, but like...
They're still in business.
God.
They recently put the Double Dragon trilogy on like Shield TV or some shit. So they're still doing stuff. They're still kicking. I think they did the Another World 20th anniversary ports too. Which were like, they were good, so... Inconsistency.
Shame. Onwards!
Metal Slug!